He's very good at what he does. But and Pastor Brother Morgan, he had actually prayed Jesus last year in our spiritual warfare. And I didn't know these things. But just being obedient and listening to what God had. So he knew all this was going to go on. He knew he wanted a place to share this. So thank y'all very much for your time. I want to get into it this morning a little bit. I'm not going to take up a whole lot of time. We'll get back on schedule just a little bit. But this morning, I wanted to pick apart a little bit of the drama. You saw that box, this one right here, that Satan had given to me. And it was real pretty. It's real innocent looking. This was kind of like my life. And whenever I opened up that box and he put that black mask on me, that spirit of demonic oppression and suppression inside of me that I carried for 20 years. And Satan couldn't use drugs, he didn't use alcohol, but he could use sex. That was my addiction. I got exposed to a very early age. And 20 years ago, and I'll write this in my book, it's out there on the desk, it's going to be released this fall. But I go a little bit more in depth about what happened. So you never, ever, ever, ever want to leave that door open. Just like the door opened for Satan to come in. He came in, and he stayed and resided for about 20 years until Jesus came in and surrendered. You know, that's key, girls, that's key. You know, you can want to be free. You can have the hurt, you can have the tears, but until you surrender, you're not going to get off from plan A to plan B.
Amen.
And I also want to point out that whenever we started the drama, Satan was behind me. Yeah, you know, that's where he needs to stay.
Amen.
Locked up behind. You know, and I've followed Satan, like I said, for 20 years. You know, I thought I was a Christian. I grew up in church. I went, you know, Sunday school, Sunday night, Wednesday night. I thought I was a Christian. But girls, until you have that relationship,
Amen.
It's not just a prayer. It's a relationship Amen. With your Father.
Amen.
Just like my Father just pulled that mask off of me, is Jesus Christ. He can bring you back to life as well. I'm just going to kind of tip down through here a little bit. But the process of restoration is the freedom that took a process. And it was that chain after chain after chain coming off. And some of you girls at Faith Walk, you know that I do a drama as well as far as the chains. Some of those little things. So if you think about a little chain, just not the link a little bit smaller than that. Those are just little habits that we have that we can let Satan rule in our lives. Then we have a medium-sized chain, and those are just a little bit bigger. You know, we may have things that we just kind of get rid of in our lives. It's a little bit stronger than habits. And then we got the big, thick chains. And those are our addictions. And caffeine can be an addiction. Mm-hmm. Sex can be an addiction. Anything that plays the place of Jesus Christ doesn't need it in your life. Okay? And that's what we're here today, is to empower women to break free from those things in their life. Also, Isaiah 41:10. This is a scripture that God gave me. It says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed." Don't be disheartened. Don't give up. I am your God. I will strengthen you, which means I will put strength in your body from the top of your head to the soles of your feet. I will help you, and I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Just like Brother Morgan took my hands, and he pulled me up as Jesus. God's going to do the same thing for you, no matter where you are, no matter what's going on. But in the important things God also wants you to remember today, when you leave out of here, those still quiet moments, when you lay your head down at night, when you get off by yourself, wherever it is in your house, things get real quiet, things get real dark, and things get real still. That's when that battlefield is going to start going off. And anybody else can relate? You have to remember, just because you're in that dark, quiet time, remember who came in that front door, and you let him, you usher him in, just like we did Jesus. You usher him in here So he goes here and here, and it comes out through your actions. He breaks the chains off of you. And like I said, it's a process. It may not happen overnight. Mine took 7 years of total surrender. I didn't get totally delivered up until about almost 2 years ago. And it's just been a process. But I had to surrender. I'm going to share a couple of scriptures with you as well. We talked about sexual addictions this morning. That was the key. That was the ticket for me. But this is what God says about sexual addictions. In Romans 1:24, it says, God delivered them over in their cravings of their hearts to sexual impurity, so that bodies were degraded among themselves. They exchanged the truth of God for a lie and worshipped and served something and created instead of the Creator, who is forever praised. This is why God delivered them over to the degrading passions. Okay, see if this don't sound a little familiar, what we're watching on television, what we're seeing on radio, or hear on radio, people at work talk about things, people in our families talk about things. It says, this is why God delivered them over to degrading passions, for even their females exchanged natural sexual relations for unnatural ones. The males in the same way also left natural relations with females, and they were inflamed in their lust for one another. Males committed shameless acts with males and received in their own persons the appropriate penalty of the error. And because they didn't think it was worthwhile to acknowledge God, this is where they blubbered up. God delivered them over to a worthless mind to do what was morally wrong. You can step out of His will, and you choose not to do this, He will let you go. And He will let you fall flat on your face. But the flip side of that, praise God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in heaven. He chose us before the foundation of the world to be holy and blameless in His sight. In love, He predestined us to be adopted through Jesus Christ. We have redemption in Him through His blood. Because if it was not that blood that was right there on that cross, we would not be here.
Amen.
We would not be here. We also have received an inheritance in Him, and we are predestined according to the purpose of the one who works out everything in agreement with the decision of God's will. So that we already have our hope in the Messiah, and we might bring praise and glory to Him. Girls, this is what we are planned and purposed for. For the world was created. He knew you guys were going to be right here today. He knew all this was going to be going on. And He knew that He has a plan. He has a purpose for y'all. Just like He does for me and Sister Lynn. And my prayer for you is to walk in your plan and purpose. In the chains, anything that's got you bound up, today is a good day to release them.
Yes.
Today is a good day to surrender and say, no more, Satan, you cannot have me.
Yes.
I am a child of God. I am not connected anymore. So with that being said, I'm going to end it right there. And thank you very much. Like I said, my book is out there on the table for a sign-up. It is releasing in the fall. I go into detail about my warfare and about my 20 years, but what God has done.
Amen.
It's the first of many. And Miss Beth Rogers, she is publishing it for us. And so I thank you, ladies, for coming this morning. Thank you.
Woo-hoo! Wow. That drama was awesome.
Yeah.
Wow, I'm such a visual person. If I see it, I can do it kind of thing. And I love what I'm seeing over here, because on the front side of the cross is freedom. On the back side is all the addictions and all the bad stuff that happened. And that's so like Jesus. He just, He puts it behind us. Amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. Well, ladies, we're going to take a short break. Let you go to the restroom, get a drink of water, whatever it is you want to do, just stretch your legs. the jump jacks, Deborah, whatever you want to do. And then we're going to meet back in here in about 5 to 10 minutes, and we're going to go back at this thing. Amen?
Amen.